love it or hate it, and there were plenty who did both. It was widely read. And the Rhino's founder says it was never shy about its coverage. Rhino readers will remember the paper's annual salaries report, a look at who's earning what in city and county government, as well as the public schools.
It's one of the things that I'm really proud of is that I think our governments here are much more open, and there's much more information available here than in other communities because of us. I think that's something that we have accomplished.
The paper published a 92-part series by writer Jerry Bledsoe titled Cops in Black and White, a look at the turmoil inside the Greensboro Police Department and the firing of its former chief, David Ray. There were also countless stories about former Guilford County Commissioner Skip Alston, whose politics clashed with the Rhino.
We miss him. He provided so many good headlines for us and some good pictures.
Whether it was Skip Alston, the school board, the city council, or the county commission, the Rhino always took one view.
We've always had a point of view. And we've written from a conservative point of view. We believe in, you know, less government, lower taxes, and that's always been our theme.
In case you were wondering, the Rhino was named after the one-time Greensboro bar with the same name. The Rhino's website says that the paper is hundreds of thousands of dollars in debt. John Hammer says for 21 years, the paper was free. If readers would like to make a donation and help out, pay those bills, that would be fine with him. In Greensboro, I'm Bill O'Neill reporting. Back to you.